Hello everybody and welcome back to Train Simulator 2017. First of all, let's read what the message says. Oh, too late, it's gone. Anyway, just telling us to pick up passengers. And we're going to be driving this, the Class 156. Now, you may notice this is slightly different than the bog standard 156 that you get on Railworks. This is because this is using the a Reskin by Super Owls. There will be a link in the description, there should be. Hopefully I've done that. of where you can download this from. Let's just get this all ready. Gap buzzes off.
Hello, mate. Test message from 156 NRN radio, over.
Message received, loud and clear, over.
Right, there we go. Get us going. So yeah, we're driving on the West Highland Line South. You may remember there is the West Highland Line extension, and this is the West Highland Line South. This came out only a couple of years ago. Later, as you notice, that it's not done by the. We don't use. The stop boards, it's still the old-fashioned signals and everything. It's not done by radio transmission, so token, so it's old-fashioned token wise. Just get this train in control. There's the 30, so we can speed up a bit. Bear in mind we're going down at 164. But yeah, this is a service all the way to Maleg. we're driving the 1Y41 service. I'll just pull up the hub and show you. So here we go, we're driving this, the 0821 to Maleg, driving this ScotRail class 156 on the 1Yankee 41 0821 Glasgow Queen Street to Maleg. You will only be driving as far as Fort William. You will be calling at the following station, which we just left, which was get a bit of braking on. There's the incline to go up. The following stations, Crianlarich, 1021. I may get a lot of these wrong. Appetite Tridrum, 1032. Bridge of Orkney, 1048. Radnock, 1109. Con, 1121. Turlock, 1138. Roybridge, 1148. Springer Bridge, 1155. And Fort William, 1207. There has been reports that the 1Yankee 44 Maleg to Glasgow Queen Street is running late. This may delay us at Springer Bridge. Pick up passenger before departing. So there we go. Now you may notice this is very long scenario from that. And so we will be, I'll be driving this as far as either Radnock or Corrour. I'll work out when it's come to about an hour in this, and we'll stop it there, and we'll pick it up again next week. So you can experience the whole journey along. Also, this will be able to download. This is a part one version of the journey, which can be downloaded. Will be able to download from my Steam Workshop page. There's a link in the description for that, so you can download this and able to run along. I'm making a bit of a scenario pack for this, and I'm hoping to have it all finished by next week. So next week's video, hopefully I'll be able to tell you it's uploaded and done on UKTrainSim. It's going to have quite a few scenarios running on there, so it don't just have this one going along here on the West Highland Line South. I've also made a scenario which will also be on the thing for the West Highland expansion. with the same service, One Yankee 41, and so you drive along that bit from Fort William to Maleg. So you can do that as well if you'd like to. They could be downloaded today, like I said, from my Steam Workshop link in the description. I'll show you that, show you where it, you know, where you can get it from. I've also, there's going to be a couple of scenarios which you could be downloading on my Steam Workshop, but also some of the scenarios that will be in the scenario pack. Give you a little bit of examples. So apart from those ones, you've also got One Yankee 48 Maleg to Glasgow Queen Street, which is the return version of this service. We also do the One Yankee 44 Maleg to Glasgow Queen Street, which is quite funny, we pass that in a bit. But yeah, the One Yankee 48 Maleg to Queen Street is only, you'll only drive that from Maleg to Fort William, and in the One Yankee 44 you'll only drive that from Fort William to where we were earlier on, was it Cricklang. You can also drive the One Yankee 21 Glasgow Queen Street to Oban, which is quite good, takes you only up to Cricklang, and you could also drive the One Yankee 24 Oban to Glasgow Queen Street, starting from Cricklang and working down the rest of the line. So good little amount of scenarios. They're the ones that will probably be up on Steam Workshop. Won't be all up today because I still got to test out two of them. Right, I need to slow down for that 30. But they will be on UKTrainSim. That I will, hopefully next week I'll be able to confirm that you can download it, because one scenario I haven't done yet. I'm also going to add in the Caledonian Sleeper runs, where you drive the Class 73 on the Caledonian Sleeper. You'll have to, because the reason why they're not on, going to be downloadable on Steam, because they use the Armstrong Powerhouse, was it Mark II coaches? The newer ones he not long brought out. So they have that, and so of course you won't be able to download them. You can't put them on Steam Workshop. So that would be a, like I said, you could download that on UKTrainSim, and I will put all the rest of the scenarios, so one big bundle, it'd be on UKTrainSim for you to download, if you would do so. But I will try and, I'm trying to keep that until next week. I've got next week to finish it off. I haven't got much to do this weekend, so I can crack on with that and get them done. Finish them off, because I have the one I got to do, and I've also got to test another one out. Bear in mind, a lot of this is done during winter and spring, so a lot of it is dark. So, like, you'd be able to take the One Bravo 01 Fort William to Euston, and the One Yankee 11, One Yankee 11 Euston to Fort William. So bear in mind, they're early hours in the morning and late night running, so don't forget, you know, the way it's going to be running overall. But hopefully you'll enjoy them if you do like watching these videos, and maybe even want to enjoy the scenarios themselves, see if you could be a bit better than me than doing these, and I'll go along. I should have turned around and put these on the career scenario mode, and so then you'll have the score on it, and we can see who, I could ask you then to comment below and to say how well you'd scored. But no, I haven't done anything like that. A lot of these go out from the normal timetable that they're supposed to. I think that's because the line has changed a little bit since when this route was done, like, because the DMUs tend to have their own separate speed limits along certain sections of the line, which you notice that on the West Highland Line expansion, and the scenario on that stays to time all the way, so you can stay to realistic time the whole journey, as long as you keep up with the DMU time as long as you keep with the DMU speed limit. So that's a good one to try out if you're used to that route. Let's put a bit of braking down as we're coming to Tydum High North. Upper North, I should say, not High North. Big acceleration, just because we're still going uphill, bear in mind. I braked a little harsh there, really. So here we go, coming into our first station. As you can see, most of these train stations are passing points as well. So you'll notice that along this line. But look at the beautiful scene, it's a typical Scottish Highlands. That's at winter. Looks lovely. So, right, let's put a bit of braking on. Of course, like I said, this Reskin comes with the rolling blinds. Well, not rolling blinds. Instead of rolling blinds, you've got the electronic destination board. And of course, you would also see that it also got the... That'd be better. There we go. You can have it quite close, saying ScotRail is in operation by a Bowley, I believe. Same people that own the Great Eastern Main Line. Now runs on this. Of course, you could have the typical in-cab view as well. Right, guy gives him a buzz. Buzz back. And speed back up. So 15 mile per hour leaving here. And then, of course, then we'll speed on up to 40, as we can see in a bit. This is quite a challenging route, really. It's a lot of... not a massive deal of... running of AI, you'll find that we only pass one AI train on the whole journey, so it's not one of those ones where you're gonna, if you like your AI traffic, you might not like the scenarios, and you might not like really like the run along here, because a lot of it is quite barren looking land. But if you love keeping to speed limits, challenging environment, this route is very perfect for you, because look, now we're going up at 1 in 60, 40 mile per hour, and the speed limits change, and one minute we're going up, next minute we're going downhill. It's very challenging, I have to admit, driving the Class 73, because the stock Class 73 that we have on Train Simulator doesn't have the new ModCon engine, which is about these days. And because of that, you'll find when you come up to that, like hills like this, the train struggles and you are crawling at it at 18 miles per hour with the Caledonian sleeper and just thrashing like mad, but not a lot going on. You'll find that a lot. When I was driving along, it took forever to drive. One scenario goes from one end of the route to the other, and so you get the whole route distance, and you see the sunset and sunset and night come in and really getting dark and everything. You've passed the last trains going the opposite way, and it gets. I can see some people getting bored with it because it is a good 3.5 hour. Scenario, and yes, I did say it right, a 3.5 hour run, and this itself is a 2 hour run. If you look at the timetable, like, we started at Quiklang at 10:21 and we arrive at 12:07, so you can see we're near enough a 2 hour run itself on this. That's why I'm doing it, it's two halves, because I don't want to bore you all to death, of course. And you can enjoy looking at its beautiful scenery. Of course, you don't have to drive these all the way to the end. You could always save, go so far. Like what we'll be doing today, we'll be going so far. We'll save it van and we'll pick it up next week. And you could probably do that when driving it in, not in real life, but when you do this game yourself, driving this scenarios yourself, the long ones. I tend to do that myself with long scenarios. If I can't, depending on how much patience you've got and have it going and how much you like driving the scenario. Like this one, I love looking at the views. And I think it's mainly I got into doing a scenario around on this route. I ended up getting this route, but I haven't shown this one, this part of the route. And I've ended up doing it. I think it's because lately I've booked my holiday in September to go to the Scottish Highlands. So I'm looking forward to that a lot. So right, now we're going downhill section. So we've gone uphill and then we start going downhill. So it's now relying on doing the brakes a lot more. So see over the other, right through the window, we can see this mountain over the other side. We're going to be running on the bottom end of that in a bit. But we've got to go in, you'll see in a sec, we've got to go into like a cove and then come back out. So it's quite interesting. But yeah, you'll see we'll be halfway up here later on. Starting to speed already. That's never a good thing to be. Start doing. So now we're just running on, well, as you can see, we're just rolling, really. We're not, nothing's got no acceleration on, it's just gravity taking us downwards. Oh, bit of speeding again. But the views, of course, on this line, it's just beautiful, like, for a simulation. It's just stunning. And, you know, looking at this now, I don't know about you, it may be just because of the season it is. It's as it being winter, and as we had that cold snap not long ago, which helps with seeing the cold, the snow on the mountains and everything like that around this area. But it does make you feel cold. It's not making me feel cold, and it's not that, it's not cold at all in the house. Oh, that's a 30. Forgot that was coming up. Right, so you can probably just start seeing the ridge of the line over there. You can just see it there. You can see one of the railway bridges. So we're running there, and of course there's the bridge going downhill. And as you can see, we've got to go into this cove and then come back out. And then we'd be going along there. You can just see where we'd be running. Running later on, along the bottom end of the mountain. So yeah, it's quite interesting, like how we've got to go downwards and then come back upwards. But we do for this bit. Tell you one thing, when you're driving Class 73, you get to these downhill bits and thinking, oh yes, going faster, but you've got to limit yourself because you've got to go to 30 miles per hour. And as you can see, we go to 40 in a bit, then it flattens out and then it's going to go back uphill. And you'd be like, ah, oh, and then it just starts struggling again. And you're like, oh, you just wish you could just let it go, get a lot of, build up a lot of speed and then just go for it up the hill. Because I did think of just using the Class 67 instead on it. But the only thing was, I thought of it, but I thought, well, maybe let's try and make it realistic with the 73 doing it. If I've got time, I will add a 67, duplicate the scenarios and we'll put it with the 67s. But I don't know if I can't see me having the time to do it, sadly. I may even upload that as a different, whole different thing anyway, if I get around to it. Because I've got quite a few scenarios, which at the moment I'm in the middle of doing, not just this one. This, I've got another scenario ready for 2 weeks' time, video in 2 weeks' time, we'll be driving along. But I won't say what it is, I'll let it. Let you notice what that is when we come to it. But that should be a nice, interesting scenario as well. So I like to try and make sure that you all have a nice, interesting runs. And like I said, I'm making these scenarios, making these videos for us all to watch and everything. But I will upload the scenarios for us to all, so everyone else can actually, if you'd like to, you can play along with them as well. So we're crossing over this very curvy bridge. Coast on down again. Just concentrate on doing the brakes and the acceleration. But yeah, when we had the winter sale and all for on Steam, and not just Steam, on Just Trains, I did buy quite a few bits and products and all, which is, you know, a good time to get it when it's a bit more reduced if you've got a tight budget. It's always tempted to buy everything when it's brand new, but on certain things I will get like new because there's stuff that I've been looking forward to for a long, long time, so I will buy that when it's new because it's just, yeah, I want this. It's like when the South Wales Coastal Line came out, I bought that when it was new, when it came out, and it's because I really look forward to it. Alright, it's a local line for me, but it was something I was looking forward to. But also the the Western Main Line, because it's a local line for me, it goes from my hometown and everything, and so I purchased them when they first came out, paying a bit more of the main normal retail price for it instead of the sale price. I think I've done it to a few other little things. Because I do love the commuter routes, especially you get, and especially the ones that you get with on the South Wales and the South London line. I got that when that came out as well, because I love how the tight commuting routes, very lot of AI and very busy service and running. But you, of course, like you noticed, that I bought things from Just Trains in the sale. You know, I did that scenario, I did a video last week, driving the Just Trains Class 20, as you probably remember. Which was very good and very enjoyable to drive. I have got the sound Armstrong Powerhouse sound pack that I could add to that and improve the sounds on that, which I might do. Right, 15, so let's slow it down now. Not even doing 30 yet, it's going to be tight. Will we slow down in time? Yeah, easily. He's off the braking. So, Bridge Orkney, we're coming in now. It's weird to think, well, But now you don't have the signals and signal boxes along here, because of course it's all radio control tokened and everything along these lines. But just thinking of, think of the signaler that had to be out in this weather, very cold, chilly weather, to pull the signals down for the train to come along. But that was very interesting. Right, into the station we come. In the bushes we are. And that's a lovely stop, right outside the station building. Open the doors and let the people in. You'll find a lot of the line stations along this line, or island platforms. I guess because it is generally cheaper to build an island platform, because you're only building one platform instead of building two. So you'll find a lot of it is island platforms along these routes. Sorry, love. Just missed the train. Back up. So Rannoch, next station stop. So Rannoch next. Then we got Corrour and in Turlock. So it's going to be around Corrour or Turlock we're going to be. I don't know, Rannoch's about 15 miles away, so it might be Corrour where we're going to be. Well, we'll probably halt this video. Excuse me. Right, as you see, we're going to start going uphill again. So let's start putting that acceleration on. 45 mile per hour speed limit now. Nice long climb we got, another climb, then going up, one is 75, and then after this we'll be going up, then it goes up to 50 miles per hour the speed limit. It's, like I said, to be fair, I don't like scenarios where you kind of on your own, not a lot to do, but I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's because that, you know, in my mind I've made this, so I've enjoyed them, but I've really enjoyed taking these scenarios and driving them, because, you know, it's just more of a challenging environment instead. Lovely looking at the views, the scenery. I think it's more the challenge when you're driving it, instead of what normally you wouldn't challenge yourself doing it. And the others, it's more challenging by AI or time restraints, and this one is just challenging because you just try and keep to the speed limit as much as you can and keep the time going well. Try and keep on time. Right, 50 mile per hour now. Still climbing the 1 in 74, but we can see that is peaking in a bit. But we notice I haven't got the Armstrong Powerhouse sound pack on this sprinter. I do have it, I need to install it, probably install it again. I think I've downloaded it because I updated something, and I need to reinstall it. I love that look at the lock right below, and look at the dumper truck there driving along the road with the mountains in the distance. That's stunning, stunning views. 181, the gradient is cut, but like I said, it will be easing off very soon. And 70. We'll start accelerating down a bit. running 240. It's not really much of a gradient. Speed it up a little bit. Well, actually, it's not speeding up a little because we have to slow down to 40 in a bit, so let's just coast it along, I reckon. Let's make it easy for ourselves. It's not burn fuel for no reason. But yeah, we've got 40 mile and goes back up to 50, and then we've got a very uphill sector, as we can see. Rest by. I'll do this, we'll be slow down to 40 for sure before it, so there we go. Going up 1 in 14 now, so gradient's against us again. Slow down for a bridge or a sharp corner, probably. Yeah, that corner is quite sharp, isn't it? So I love these little bridges they've got, like the iron bridges going over the top, and oh yeah, we've got a little viaduct we're going over. Just going over the top of us, the pedestrian walkway. Right, 1 in 60, and the speed limit's gone up to 50, so this is full throttler now. Badges, because of course it's no longer owned by First ScotRail. I hate it when it's that echo sound. It does my head. One thing I did notice though when I've been driving along this route, there's no AWS at all ramp. There's no AWS ramps at all, so you can enjoy driving along but not have to respond to AWS at all. So enjoy that. Drive along, you can enjoy looking at the scenery as you plod along. Do you think they would have put AWS ramps along here? Right, speed limit's going to go back down to 40, I see. It sounds so much quieter when you get into the cab, don't it? From being outside with the echoing of the engine. 10 miles to Rannoch. Right. Just throttle down, let the gradient slow us down for this speed change. And let's throttle back up again. Very steep uphill climb this is. I should say that this has another reskin in here, not just this one, of the class 156. We also got the Caledonian reskin of the sleeper coaches being reskinned in the Caledonian livery and the Class 73, especially on this scenario, which could be which you could download from either UKTrainSim or from Caledonian Railworks website itself. There will be also be there'll be a link in the description for that in on the scenario when you go into download it on Steam Workshop. So you can click on that and go to it. I'll probably put the link of the UK TrainSim where you can download it. But you can download it directly from their website, but when you go into their page on UKTrainSim where you can download it from, it does say on there, it gives you their website where you can also download it from, which sometimes can be a bit easier so you don't have to queue up on UKTrainSim. Bit of a bank on the track here, curving around here. Right, go back up to 50 miles per hour now. So that's... wait for it, there we go. Put it back up to full throttle. Get that engine working hard again. 181 gradient. So still keep climbing. We haven't slowed down at all. Noticed the window cleaner outside. Don't often see the window cleaner. It's a very rare situation this one is. So you're doing the windows next door neighbour's windows. It's quite weird. It's weird seeing a window cleaner. All of a sudden I just saw a brush go past the window. I thought, what the hell is that? Basil the brush has come after me. It's very rare you see a broomstick fly in the air. So I was seeing things first of all. No, you could just see the see his van there outside. Window cleaning. Because they do that these days, don't they? They don't go up a ladder anymore to go wash it. I think it's because they're for safety. They use like a nylon brush on the end of a stick. Right, slow down there because we're standard speed. Yeah, they use a nylon brush, don't they, now, on the end of the stick and wash the windows that way. I noticed this, you can see it coming on the hub in a sec, two signals come along, and it's a little loop, and it's got a little platform there, and I noticed today the trains don't stop there at all, and I noticed that station, there's a state platform there that doesn't be used, and I do wonder if that's still there today. And is that loop still there today or gone? Because there's nothing showing on when you look on real time at all of this like loop existing really. So I do wonder if anyone that's watching this is local to the line and knows about it. I wonder. Put a comment below to let me know if there's actually still is a loop by here. I'm guessing that station that you're seeing is there, we're just going to go through it now. The platform, you can just start seeing the platform there, right in the corner. I'm guessing that's out of service, been out of service for a while, but anyone knows about it, let us know in the comments. Put a comment below saying what that station used to be, and also let me know if that loop is still inactive today. You know, is it still quite an important little is it still in passing point or not, or it's just all gone now and you just run straight along to Rannoch. I notice a lot of it is near enough every station has a passing point except for Roy Bridge. It's the only one that doesn't have a passing point, so I suppose you don't need, but I suppose may not need all the passing points. But I don't know, like I said, does interest me. I haven't looked up about it and before this video, because sometimes I do, but it's one of those things I forgot all about. But anyone that's watching this that knows a bit about it, put it in the comments. Be much appreciated. And also, if you do it for next week's video, I'll probably say it in the video. Let everyone else know as well, just in case they didn't see it in the comments below. Right, so still got 5 miles to go. Just look at my stopwatch of how we're going. So 40 minutes of the video has passed. I'm standard speed now. What? Barren this bit. Just looking at the... you can just see a few stones tossed about. But very, like, barren looking. But, interesting little... it's beautiful scenery along this line. Just a minute ago we were just going through along the side of the mountains and all, and through like valleys of, and now like all of a sudden we just, there's not really any mountains around us. You can see them in the distance, but we're just like in the woods kind of thing. It's very interesting how it's gone from one extreme to the other. That's quite what I love about this route. It just goes from one to the other. 1 minute you got the mountains around you, the next minute you've just got the barren scenery and then forest and it goes, like I said, like it's teeming of different types of life. So the only thing is shame they don't have, I know in the West Highlands expansion they have that every so often, you do see a random deer, don't you, on the route. And a shame it doesn't have some of them figures on this room. It just adds a little bit more to it. A random deer or stag just appear on the side of a mountain near by the line as we drive by. Right, as you can see... oh, excuse me. Yawning then. As you can see, the speed limit's going to go down to 40, then 50, so we're just slowing down to cross over a bridge, really. We'll just get ready for that in a sec. Right, let's put the brakes on. Get ready. There we go, that's plenty. So yeah, we're just crossing over this bridge and then you can see the speed limit goes back up to 50 in a sec. So it's just a short little hop over a bridge. And then accelerate it back up. Going down at 1 in 60, so we'll cut off the acceleration and let gravity take us to the speed. And get ready for the braking. Like I said, hopefully a lot of you are enjoying this beautiful scenery. It's just like I am as we're driving along this this beautiful route. It's a beautiful part of the country, to be fair. Looking forward to September for my breakaway in Scotland, and hopefully go along the Jacobite as well. Go along on the Jacobite, I should say. I love how you got the sun. It's cloudy, but you can see the sun every so often peers through, gives you that sunray shadow. Typical clattering of the track. It's to 40 and then go uphill again. It's 15, so yeah, we're not far away from Radnock now. Because I apologise how I'll probably pronounce all these places completely wrong. Drifts crossing the line, you know, end of the day, makes it easier for keep the line open at all times. Right, 15 mile per hour. So we go coming into the next station, Radnock. I believe this is like moorland, isn't it? It took them ages to put the line here. I've got a funny feeling. I think it's one of these places where it's quicker to take the train to the location than actually driving it, because it's just middle of nowhere. There you go. Open the doors, let the people on and off the train. So, Radnock. Right, I should be able to do it. Yeah, I'm going to continue all the way up to Corrour, and then we'll pause the video. Leave it there for this journey. Yeah, 7 miles, just do it nicely. 10 minutes is about. As we go about, it's about 10 minutes time, would be an hour stream videoing, so I nearly said streamer then. Gosh, that'd be a long stream. All West Highland lines run. Lovely sunlight coming onto the train as we climb along. Look at the mountains behind. Right, pop in my acceleration on because the speed limit is 30. Don't want to put too much acceleration because, like I said, it's only 30. Cross over a bridge. Watch across the bridge. Oh, look at that. There's the sun. Oh, that's just beautiful. Oh, it's just stunning. Guess they get a lot of snow drifts in this area. It's just where you can easily just pile into this bit. Right, so go into the little bridge. Goes up to 50 in a bit, so that's not too far. So I look forward to the speedo up again. Going up at 1 in 53, so doing quite well with the only 400% power. So what's that notch? 4. Should have guessed that. So we notch 4 on it, but we will notch it up to notch 7 in a sec. As the speed limit rises, so we'll speed her up now. Go to notch 7, let her climb this quite nicely. Well, as you can see, the it is going to level out in a bit, so in a sec. There you go, you can see the fencing coming along, I guess, like I said, to stop the snow drifts. And I guess that tunnel, like the bridge that we got just ahead of it, is because it's too much. They've made like a tunnel kind of thing for the train to go under to let the snow, so it doesn't build up with too much snow drift, I'm guessing. So it's easier to keep us running that way. Right, here we go. Excuse me, yawning again. As you can see, it levels out and then starts climbing again, so leveling out might be quite nice for us. Yeah, a bit more of us. Well, I wouldn't say we worry too much about the speed we can do, because this engine's quite powerful enough to get us quite decent speed up. Excuse me. I just love looking at the water and the rocks. Just looks lovely at this wintry look. Probably all be frozen over. Being all this snow and winter. And how cold it gets up here. Right, start climbing again, 1 in 79. 1 in 79. So quite a steep gradient, but as you can see, it does peter out in a bit again. Notch 6. 7. Still power is up there, that one. I've done it before, I did 304. I think you can download the stuff downloaded on UKTrainSim. Did a scenario once before on the I think it was, yeah, it was the Just Trains East Coast Main Line route, and you're driving the Northern Aviva Northern livery 156. And I just put in notch 7 and just drive along when you got onto the East Coast Main Line. You want to know anywhere to stop. And of course this is limited to 75 miles per hour, to say there. Of course this thing powers all the way up to 80 odd. And yeah, it got to a corner, which, you know, I think the corner was 100 mile per hour, and you thought, well, we should do fine over this, and she toppled over. It went over quite easy. It was something to see. So all of a sudden he sat here in the cab, and the next thing, over we go, on the corner. Yeah. Learned next time, always limit myself down to 75, and respect the maximum speed limit of the train. And don't try and push it harder. As it doesn't get you anywhere. Just gets you to fail the scenario and then restart after we do it again. Right, as we can see, 2.6 miles to go to Corrour, so not too far away now. Stopwatch is saying it's coming up to 58 minutes gone past, so it's not too bad. Be there not soon enough. I love seeing the little huts every so often when you go along the line. Just for the worker huts. But it's interesting working out here in the middle of nowhere. I don't think you get complaints of if you started tamping down the track around here in the more late night, in the nights, or even in the days. You'll get much complaints of noise. Just in the middle of nowhere. Right, speed limit's going to 45, and as we can see, the 15 mile per hour coming up. As we can also see, is Corrour has got a very short platform, and only one coach will actually be able to have the doors open, so you have to bear that in mind. Start accelerator now. As we're going uphill again. But then after this, it's all pretty much downhill, as we would have hit the highest point of the line. And there'll be a little sign near the top of here telling us that. So not too far to go then. Seeing the mountains just ahead of us, still quite dormant. It's just weird how like it's barren and you got these rocks every so often. Like earlier on, we had the rocks and it was just all forest around us, and it's changed again. There's no forest at all around here. It's just nothing. So the line just runs through like middle of nowhere pretty much, but it's beautiful scenery. It's just something to hold. Right, there's the distance signal for the signal coming up. Go now. Right, shut down the accelerator. Just let us just coast the rest of the way in, as we've got 50 mile per hour speed limit coming up. As always around these loops, so not too far. that a go. Bit of braking now. Slow us down. And there's the station right in front of us. Right, it does look more like in the middle of nowhere. So most of these stations look like they're in the middle of nowhere. Do you think what type of people comes and gets on and off these trains? Where did it come from? Right, here we come, coming into here, this station. Corrour. Very short platform, as you can see. You can fit the both cars on here, but you won't be able to open the door, so you've got to bear that in mind. Oh, wrong button. And open those doors. So that's pretty much where I'm going to leave it for this bit. I hope you enjoyed that. If so, don't forget to put a little like at the bottom of the video. Comment below anything I discussed about in this video, or anything you'd like me to talk about as well on the journey onwards down. We'll be continuing along on this scenario on the West Highland Line South, from here at Corrour all the way to Fort William. So, hope to see you then next week. If you enjoyed this and haven't done so already, or may have watched other videos and enjoyed them too, why don't you push that subscribe button? You can keep up to date and follow us all the way on down to Fort William next week. Should be quite good. Like I said, there'll be a link. There's a link in the description for where you can get the reskin for this from the 156, as well as the link in there for my Steam page, where you can get the download these scenarios for yourself and drive them yourself as well. There's also be a link in the description where you can follow me on Facebook and Twitter. I'll be back again next Monday, racing on Motorsport Manager. On the Wednesday, be trucking through Europe on Euro Truck Simulator 2, hopefully still doing our little Tour de France that we've been doing lately. And we'll be back again next Friday, continuing on from here to Fort William on Train Simulator 2017. So I hope to see you then in one of these videos, or even next week. Until next time, bye for now.